Welcome into our first major integration technique, U-substitution. And what I want us to think of U-substitution as the backwards direction of the chain rule. So let's try to piece that together on what I mean. So let's say I take the derivative with respect to x of the composition of functions, right? So I'm going to have to perform the chain rule in order to solve. Again, I know I'm leaving it very abstract. We'll do an example soon. So if we take the derivative, I get the derivative of the outside function. I leave the inside alone. Leave it alone. And the derivative of the inside function, I get g prime of x. Right? Easy enough. Right? Just the chain rule. So now what happens if I want to go backwards? Right? So what I mean, right, what's happening here is I'm going in this direction, taking the derivative. Right? So how do I go backwards? Well, let's just see what happens here. So if I take the integral of both sides, so we'll do the integral here of the derivative of f of g of x. Let's make sure I get all my parentheses. One here, one there, and one more. G of x dx, and I set this equal to the other side, in which I will also be taking the integral of f prime, let's see, g of x, there we go, g prime of x dx. Well, by the fundamental theorem of calculus, right, the integral of the derivative, well, that's just all going to go away. And so over here, I'm just going to be left with f of g of x, right? So our original function is going to be equal to, and maybe we have a plus c. I forgot the plus c. That's fine. Is equal to the integral, right, of this over here. Right, so it's taking this into account, and how will we solve it, right? And we're going to introduce the concept of U substitution. But again, I just want us to understand this is just going to be the backwards direction of the chain rule, right? Chain rule is the derivative. U substitution is going to be the integral. Right, so let's write down an example here of taking the derivative. So just so we can see what it should be, let's take the derivative here. And then we'll work on the integral of, let's do x squared plus 1 cubed. Right, so if I take the derivative, I have a chain rule. The 3 comes down in front. The inside stays the same. I finish the rest, right, of this product rule here. And the derivative of the inside is 2x. Awesome. So let's leave that as such. Right, and I'm going to underline it so we don't forget about it. So now let's say we take this side, the side that I'm underlining here, and I want to take the integral, right? So how do I go back? So let's write out this integral over here. So we have the integral. I'm going to combine these two ideas, 3 and 2x. Two ideas or two, right, pieces. Times x squared plus 1 squared dx. Right, now what I want to do here is pick my u, right? So u substitution, I'm going to pick something to be a u here. And I'm going to set it equal to the piece in which I take its derivative, I will get the other or part of the other, right? So you'll notice here if I take the derivative of 6x, I just get 6. That's not going to help me. If I take the derivative of x squared plus 1, I'm going to get 2x, very similar to 6x. So maybe we can work with that. So again, we're undoing the chain rule. And now if I take the derivative of u, of course I end up with du, derivative of x squared plus 1, 2x dx. Okay, now it's very close to 6x. Again, we're going to see how this substitution happens in a second. Just to make this a little bit more obvious, I'm going to rewrite the 6x. Right, so I'm going to rewrite it kind of how it was before as such. So here's 2x. X squared plus 1 squared dx. Okay, And now we're kind of set up for success here. So we're going to rewrite this integral, except we're going from X land or X territory, right, to U territory, right? That's what this U is for. If we're hoping that by switching over to U's, the integral would become easier to solve. So let's rewrite it. I'm not going to do anything with this 3. The 3 stays in place, right? And now the reason why I've wrote it as such is because what do we notice? 2x dx is equal to du, right? So we're, instead of writing 2x dx, we're just going to write, well, we know it's equal to du. And I'm going to do the same thing here. What do I notice about my x squared plus 1? Right, x squared plus 1 is equal to u. So this is u squared. Now this is a fairly easy integral to solve, right? This is a reverse power rule in which I have my 3. I'm just going to add 1. So I'm going to end up with u cubed over 3. And of course, we don't want to forget our plus c. And what do we notice with the 3s? They cancel out, right? And just go ahead and cancel. And now we don't want to go from x to u and just stay in u. We want to go back to x's, right? So what did u equal? Well, u was equal to x squared plus 1. So let's just substitute back in. So we end up with x squared plus 1 cubed plus c. Right, and now what do we notice? Well, I'll put a plus c over there too, but the x squared plus 1 cubed, right, similar to what we started with, right? So again, we're just undoing the chain rule. Now the plus c is just in case we had any constants, right? If we took the derivative and there was a constant hanging out over here, right, the derivative would be 0, so we want to know if we want to get that back. But in this case, we just leave it as such, right? So we're going to go through a bunch of more examples in the following parts of this video, but hopefully this was a good start. Again, we want to think about undoing the chain rule, right? If I take the derivative, I do the chain rule, how do I go back? So I will see you in the next parts of the video. All right, welcome in. Let's go ahead and do some examples. Now, feel free to pause the video, try to solve these out. They're all U substitution problems. All right, here we go. So again, we want to pick our u. What is going to help us simplify this once we go into u territory? In this case, we're going to set u equal to, we have 1 minus x squared. What happens if we take the derivative of u? We get du. What happens if we take the derivative of 1 minus x squared? We will get negative 2x dx. Now notice, this is very close to what we have left over, right? We have a 2x. So instead, we have a negative 2x, let's just move the negative to the other side, right? So the negative on the other side would just be negative 1 du is equal to 2x dx, perfect. Okay, now let's make our substitutions for everything. And so what do we end up with? Let's write our integral. Instead of writing 2x dx, we have a negative 1 du, which leaves us with just a 1 here in our numerator. And instead of writing 1 minus x squared, I set that equal to u. I will write this as u to the 8th. Awesome. Okay, now let's write this out one more time because I like negative exponents. If we're going to integrate, this is going to be equal to the integral of, we'll leave the negative on the outside, this is u to the negative 8 du. And now this is a fairly straightforward integral, right? We're going to add 1, which is going to make it negative 7, and divide. So in our case, we're going to end up with equals negative on the outside. We have u to the negative 7 over negative 7 plus c. Well, we have two negatives. Those are going to cancel each other out. And again, we're just going to go back to x territory, which means our u becomes 1 minus x squared. So our final answer here is going to be 1 minus x squared to the negative 7th plus c. Awesome. Okay? And that is going to do it. So we'll leave that one there. Let's move on to the next one. Same idea. What do we want to pick to be our U? Our U is going to be whatever makes our equation easier to solve once we go to U territory, right? So if I take the derivative of W minus natural log of W, what happens is I end up with exactly this over here, right? So that's going to help me out in the future. So U is equal to W minus natural log of W, which means, right, du is going to be 1 minus 1 over W dW. And now we can make our substitution. Let's switch everything out. So we have our integral. And instead of writing 1 minus 1 over W dW, I know that's equivalent to du. And instead of writing W minus natural log of W, I know that's equal to my U. So in this case, we just end up with the very easy integral, U du, reverse power rule, right? We end up with U squared over 2 plus C. And again, if we go from W's to U's, we gotta go back to W's. So let's go ahead and do so. In this case, U is equal to W minus natural log of W squared. And of course, this is over 2. And you can put the 1 half out in the front. That's fine. Plus C. Don't forget the plus C. And one more time. Now, this one's not as obvious as looking at it. So we're going to just rewrite it, but a little bit differently. So this is natural log of x times 1 over x dx. And maybe at this point, it becomes a little bit more obvious as to what we set our u to be, right? So if we set u to be natural log of x, we have du is going to be equal to 1 over x dx. So same idea, let's make the substitutions, right? What happens here? Instead of writing 1 over x dx, I'm going to replace it with a du. And instead of writing natural log, I'm going to replace it with a u. And again, I see the same right u integral as before, in which now we end up with the same thing, u squared over 2 plus c. And in this case, our u is equal to just natural log. So we'll rewrite it. Our final answer will be, we have u squared, so I'll just put the 1 half first. 1 half natural log of x squared plus c. And I believe natural log properties will help us simplify it, but we'll leave it as such for now. All right, so hopefully these three examples helped. In the preceding part or following parts of these videos, we're going to go through a few more examples. So they will get increasingly harder. I will see you in the upcoming parts. Okay, let's jump into level 2. Right, so still both U substitution problems as with this whole video, but what do we do now? Right, so what do we set to be our U? Notice two things. If I take the derivative of cosine, I end up with a negative sine, right? But if I take the derivative of sine, I end up with a cosine. So it almost appears that we can do either one, but that's not the case, right? The thing that's messing everything up is this 3. But if we don't notice that at first, it's okay to try, right, and see what works for us. So let's go ahead and we'll start off with the wrong one, right? The wrong one here being, let's set u equal to cosine, and let's see what happens. So u is equal to cosine, which means that du is going to be equal to negative sine x dx. But the issue is going to be that even though I can make this substitution with the u, and I have my du set equal to sine, the issue is that I have 3 of them here, right? Sine times sine times sine. And this du is only going to allow me to get rid of one of them, right? So instead of going in this direction, And you could plug these in and see that it would not work, right? So we'll put like an X through it, right? Instead of going in this direction, let's go ahead, we'll set U equal to sine, which means that du is going to be equal to cosine of x dx. And let's see if I can get a different marker here so we don't have to hear that. And now let's see what happens when I make this substitution. Right, so let's rewrite the integral. I have, instead of cosine of x dx, I have a du. And instead of writing sine cubed, right, I said u is equal to sine, so this is now just going to be u cubed. And now this is a very easy integral for us to solve, another reverse power rule, in which we get u to the fourth over 4 plus c. And again, we don't want to go from x's to u's and stay in u's, so let's switch back to x's, where I said u is equal to sine. So in this case, I have 1/4 sine to the 4th of x plus c. Don't forget the plus c here, right? If we forget the plus c, we've written one answer. If we write plus c, we have infinite answers. Good. Okay, going over here, same idea. This one's a little bit more, even though tan and secant squared probably scare some people, it's a little bit more obvious as to what we choose, because if I set u equal to my bottom, right, the derivative of tangent is going to give me the secant squared, right? Derivative of secant squared is not going to give me the tangent. Right, so we're going to say let's have u equal 3 minus tangent of 4t. Which means that du is going to be equal to, well, derivative of 3, 0. We do have a negative sign, so let's not forget about that. So we end up with negative secant squared of 4t times the derivative of the inside, right? So don't forget about the derivative of the inside, which is just 4. We're going to rewrite this here. Oh, and let's not forget about our buddy dt hanging on there. So let's go ahead and rewrite our du just so it doesn't look so out of place. Du is going to be equal to, we'll bring the 4 forward, negative 4 secant squared of 4t and dt. Good. Now we're going to make these substitutions. However, what do we notice? That here, right, we only have a secant squared 4t, and over here we have negative 4. So maybe we move that negative 4 to the other side, right? And again, you don't have to do this. I'm just trying to make it a little bit more obvious as to when we go solve here in a second. That negative 1/4 du is going to be equal to secant squared 4t dt. I gotta get a new yellow marker, huh? Okay. Now let's make all of our substitutions and rewrite our integral. So our integral becomes negative 1/4 on the outside. The integral of, well, we're left with, this was a secant squared, this is a secant squared 4t dt. We're left with just the negative 1/4 du, so we'll just put the du over here. And instead of writing 3 minus 4t, or tan of 4t, sorry, right, we know that's just going to be our u. So we have 1 over u. And where does a 1 over u come from? What happens, or what function when I take the derivative would give me a 1 over u? So take your time, think about it, maybe pause the video. We end up with negative 1/4 natural log of u plus c. Plus c. And of course, we went from t territory to u territory. We want to go back to t's. So our final answer is going to be equals negative 1/4 natural log of 3 minus, and of course maybe absolute value signs would help here to be entirely correct, tan of 4t. And don't forget the plus c. Awesome. Right, so that is it. Again, just taking one more step up. These should be a little bit more difficult than the previous problems, and we will go one more level. So I will see you in the next level. All right, you've finally made it to level 3. Let's go ahead and jump into these problems starting over here. Right, so the integral of x over 1 minus x dx. Right, so let's go ahead. We're going to set our u equal to 1 minus x. And we're just going to follow the pattern. Right, that means our du is going to be equal to negative 1 dx, or negative dx. That's fine. So maybe we stare at this point, we stop. What's our issue? Well, our issue is, okay, great, we can replace the 1 minus x, and maybe we could even move over the negative sign. That's fine to solve for dx. But what about this x up here? What do we do with it? And what we're going to use is a relationship we've already set up. We know what u is equal to, which means we can also set what x is equal to, right? So in our case, x is equal to 1 minus u, right? Just by switching, just performing some algebra there, switching those around. So now resetting up our integral, let's go ahead and switch everything over to u's now. We have the integral instead of x, we're going to write 1 minus u. And instead of 1 minus x, I'm going to write u. And instead of dx, I'm going to write negative du, right? I need to move that negative sign over. So negative du. Okay, progress. Now, what can we do with this? Well, we can split this into two different pieces, right? This is the same thing as the integral of 1 over u minus, and let's not forget the minus sign here too from the beginning, minus 1, right? U over u. We have 1 over u minus u over u, or 1 du. Okay. And what does this finally equal? Well, in our case, right, let's go ahead. We have negative. Where does a 1 over u come from? This is a natural log of u. Negative, negative. Where does a 1 come from? A u, so plus u. And of course, a plus c. And we're not quite done because we went from x territory to u territory. Now we want to go back to... Yes, you are right. We want to go back to x's. So this is equal to natural log of x. Did I write the wrong thing here? Let's switch it up. Yes. Real quick. Erase, erase. Edit out. 1 minus x plus 1 minus x plus, ooh, there we go. Awesome. All right, so again, in this case, both of these problems are going to be similar, in which we can substitute out multiple things using u here. All right, so in this case, right, we substituted out the 1 minus x. We found the relationship of what x is equal to as well in terms of u, and we can almost make this double substitution, and it makes our problem able to be solved. And so we want to use that same idea over here. All right, so what we're going to do... So we're going to say, well, let's let u be equal to 1 minus x to the 4th, which means du is going to be equal to negative 4x cubed dx, of course. Okay. So a little bit of progress. What I'm going to do before we even go forward is I'm going to rewrite this integral so maybe it looks a little bit more familiar as to what we should do here. This is x to the 4th times x cubed. So there's our x cubed all over 1 minus x to the 4th dx. Okay. And so we're going to move this negative 4 over, right? So then it does give us this negative x cubed, right? So let's just write that now. We do have negative 1/4 du is equal to x cubed dx. That's great. But there's also one more thing we're looking for here, right? So let's just look at what we could substitute out. The 1 minus x to the 4th can go away. The dx, right, x cubed, right, can go away. We're left with this x to the 4th, though, but what do we know about our original relationship? We can solve for x to the 4th, right? We know that x to the 4th is equal to 1 minus u. And so now we can go ahead and start setting everything up. We have our integral. Instead of x to the 4th, we have 1 minus u. 1 minus u. Instead of writing x cubed dx, we're going to write negative 1/4 du. We'll put the du out here. And instead of writing the square root of 1 minus x to the 4th, right, I'm just going to write u to the 1/2. Ooh, that's a little squeaky and not super clean. I'll try to clean that up in our next integral here. Okay, so now we're at a point where maybe it's still looking unfamiliar, but we're going to use the same method where we distribute the denominator to each piece, right? So this ends up being the integral of, well, now I've messed it up. We'll put the negative 1/4 on the inside for right now in the hopes of moving it out later. And we have 1 over u to the 1/2, which gives me u to the negative 1/2. And I have u over u to the 1/2, so minus u to the 1/2 du. Okay, now we will bring out this negative 1/4 one more time. And so now this is just some reverse power rules, right? So I'm going to add one. We'll put the negative 1/4 out here. We're going to add one, so u to the 1/2. U to the 1/2. And instead of dividing by 1/2, we're going to just multiply by the reciprocal, which is a 2. Minus, and we're going to add one, so we have u to the 3/2. And instead of dividing by 3/2, we will multiply by the reciprocal, 2/3. And of course, we're going to have a plus c. Right, so finally, let's finish this all out. What was our u? Our u was 1 minus x to the 4th. And we're also going to distribute in this negative 1/4. Right, so this is going to be equal to negative 1/4 times 2, negative 1/2. And instead of writing u to the 1/2, we have 1 minus x to the 4th. Minus, double minus, so plus, we're going to have 2/3 times 1/4, or it's going to be 1/6, right? So we're going to have plus 1/6. And instead of u, right, we're going to have 1 minus x to the 4th to the 3/2 plus c. And that is our final answer. So maybe watch that one a few times. Again, this one's very involved. We set our u. We ended up using that relationship twice to get rid of many x's. We took our derivative. We had to move some stuff around. Right, if we understand this one, I have a really good feeling that we'll understand all of our u sub problems that we will run into. So hopefully you guys enjoyed the video. If you have any questions, comments, please leave them below. I will see you in some videos to come. Thanks, guys.